So, this is a Hoermie. It's a bobblehead doll. It's supposed to be me. We give these Hoermies away at our annual holiday party. I have the honor of giving them away. I have a little thing that I say every year. I don't know if I'm going to get a chance to say it this year, but it's a little statue with a lifetime of stature. The Hoermies. I look forward to giving these awards away this year.
All right, so Eric, tell me, what's your plan? This looks good.
So this is what I'm going to do. I got my everything worked up. I hit the fog machine. Boom. There it goes. You're up on stage.
That is awesome.
You're singing.
Yeah.
Boom. Pyrotechnics in the front. Boom. 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 On the top. I'm going to create them all in my garage. It's going to be rocking. Rocking.
Oh, my God, man. This is going to be the best ever. You nailed it, brother. You nailed it. Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like what you're doing.
Bam.
Bam. Hang it up.
Here we go now.
Everybody working all day for their wages and pay. But today we take a break, cause it's time for a holiday. This is what we work for. This is what we play for. This is what we do. It's Hoermies time for you. Here we go now. One more time. This is my rap. And this is my mind.
Come on. Enough.
Hey, Jesse.
Enough. We've already talked about this. No more party. Stop playing.
But here's the one.
Stop.
One.
Enough.
Eric, we gotta talk, man.
What?
I think she's right. Have a seat, man. I think it's over. She's been trying to tell me this for at least a couple months now. Our party budget is just absolutely at zero, if not less than that. It was that summer party, you remember the petting zoo?
The bomb.
But we spent way too much, and something's gotta give, and she's right. She's been telling me the Hoermies, I think, are out, pal. I think we're done. Maybe we can use the pyrotechnics next year, because it is an awesome idea. God, it's
disappointing. Yeah, let's just quit. I mean, that's what we do, right? We just quit. Like, you know, when Fonz was out in California and Potsy was like, yeah, Fonz, nobody can jump a shark with a leather jacket on. Yeah. And Fonz didn't listen. He didn't quit. He did it. And he jumped that shark. He's an American hero because of it.
I never watched Laverne and Shirley, but I know what you're saying. Your point is well taken. Quitters don't jump sharks.
Thanks. With leather jackets.
That's right. And if no matter what they're wearing, they need to do what they need to do to get things done. And that's what this firm is built on. That's what wins these Hoermies. That's the reason I have these couple of Hoermies right here. And, you know, Eric, it's the attitude that you just made sure I remembered is what wins these Hoermies. And you may get one of these things one day. I mean, that's a fantastic attitude, Eric. Yeah. Now, hold on. We'll have to do the Hoermies, pal. You are absolutely right. I appreciate your words. We're going to get these things done. We're going to get these things done. Thank you.
Don't be Chachi. Be the Fonz.
The Fonz, Chachi. I did see Joni Loves Chachi. What happened to him? After he was in the...
I think he did the Karate Kid, buddy.
He did the Karate Kid. That's a fantastic
movie. Wax on.
Well, as we've all learned, life is sometimes just a series of setbacks, especially when you've got Jessica in the accounting department slashing budgets at every turn. I don't know why she wants to slash the Hoermies, everyone's favorite party. But this year we weren't able to have it at the Stagger, and we've had it the last 2 years. And they've been very successful. I might add that my picture still hangs at the Stagger Inn with the word Gobert, the French word for rock star underneath it. So, been working all night trying to get the office ready, this new budget crunch, but as they say, every great party begins with the food.
Good, how are you?
I need several, I think three buckets of chicken.
9187.
Okay, thanks.
No problem.
This is going to be great.
God, it smells great in here.
Okay. Here's the deal. We had to cut some things, and it's okay. We're going to make the best of it. We went and got buckets of chicken. We got some mashed potatoes. There's no reason we can't make this look like an incredibly beautiful presentation. We want people to feel like it's been catered, okay? Mm-hmm. Can you guys handle this?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Mashed potatoes. We got a scooper here. Have you guys been to any nice restaurants?
Never. No.
Okay. Don't worry about that. They usually serve mashed potatoes in a wonderful mound, right? A beautiful mound. So it's going to be a scoop. That's probably too much, right? What do you think, Eric? Too much?
It's a lot, but it's...
Scoop it. Drop it. Do you guys see that?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Scoop it, drop it. Now, the key is we can either dump the gravy on there, right? Do we want to dump the gravy on there? Good. You guys are going to be great. Instead, we're going to put the gravy into this dish, just like that. Oh, oh, that is a good gravy. Look at that.
That is good.
It is so thick, it won't even go into the bottle. There we go. See that? You just squeeze that.
You guys watching?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Squeeze that.
Just squeeze it.
Squeeze that thing right there to the bottom.
Squeeze it.
Pull it out. And put that in there so you don't make too much of a mess. There's a top here somewhere. Thank you very much.
We're not paying for you to clean up your own messes.
All right, and then, all right, do we dump it?
No.
Do we dump it?
No.
Drizzle it.
Thank you. We gotta start drizzle. Drizzle. You guys got it?
Yep. Got it.
Chicken it. Chicken it. Chicken it.
Get chicken and put it on the plate.
Chicken
please.
The plate, please.
This has gotta be nice. See. It's the Hoermies.
Perfect guess. Perfect guess.
Needs no introduction, but let's show them what we got.
We got like 1 minute. Everybody's here. They're all seated. It is time, buddy.
So excited.
Oh my God. Okay. All right. Help me out with these things.
Absolutely.
Help me out with these
Absolutely.
Things. Why am I wearing these again?
Because you're the champ.
All right.
You're the heavyweight king.
I got it.
You're the man.
Tell me again. Tell me why
you're
I'm
the
wearing
man. Tell me
you're
why the I'm man. Wearing. Come on.
Tell me
come
why
on.
I'm
you're
wearing.
The
tell
man.
Me. Tell me.
You're
tell
the
me
man.
Again. Tell me again.
Do it.
We are ready. Let's go.
Let's go. Do it. Come on.
Let's go.
Oh.
Focus. Oh, fix it, baby.
What day
fix
is it,
baby? It
what
is day
one.
It's day zero.
Day is it?
It is zero time. Yes!
Hoermies. Quiet. Focus up. Eye of the tiger, it's the criminal fight. Rising up to the challenge of fighters.
TorHoerman! TorHoerman! TorHoerman.
Boy, that is exciting. Can you guys hear me? The first Hoermie Award is for the city of big shoulders, the city that works. It's a city that, it's a big city. It's a big city, people work. They got big shoulders in that city. That's what it's all about. This award for the third straight year goes to the man with the biggest shoulders in the office. Todd Rhodes. Come on up here, Todd.
Todd Rhodes.
Come on up here, Todd. Thank you, guys. Todd. Congratulations, buddy.
Congratulations. Alright, so did he just call me fat? Just give me the fat Hoermie and we'll all be happy.
The next award this year is for this is on, in honor of the state of Illinois that we all come from. Wonderful state.
It is the state where the man we all know and love came from. A man named Abraham Lincoln. Honest Abe. A man of freedom, a man of liberty. And I want to give this award to somebody that personifies freedom. Liberty. A newfound freedom. This was hard to figure out. I worked hard on this one. But I figured the person that needs it most right now, the person who has newfound freedom, is Kelly Postal. Kelly, come on up. Congratulations, Kelly.
My divorce?
So the last one, obviously, is the one we give every year. It's not one we change, it's one we keep the same. It's the governor's trophy. The governor's Hoermie. Because we all know...
You know, I don't know that it's the best idea to name an award after governors in a state. They tend to end up in jail.
People right in front of him that should be winning these awards. I mean, you know, what about me? What do I give so much? SARS 2 years in a row, just ridiculous. It's self-serving, narcissistic.
The person that stands for what we stand for, which is SARS. We all know what SARS is, right?
It starts with success, and then achievement, which leads to results, and it brings you back to success again.
He named the mantra after disease. That kills people. SARS? Really? SARS? That's the best you can come up with? A disease that kills people? And that's what you want our motto to be?
And I want to give this award away every year. And you all know that I've won it a couple of years in a row. And I think it is time for that to end. But it's not this year. Because this award needs integrity. We have to give these awards to the people that most deserve them. And when you get this award, which I hope all of you do, over the years, it's going to be because you just, it's going to be because you deserve it, because you earned it, because you represent SARS. So this year the award goes one more time to me, TorHoerman. Let's give it up one more time.
The Hoermies. Once you get them, they never go away, and they only come up about once a year. Maybe more if you're lucky. So I can't wait for next year.
Well, what started off as a potential disaster, I think worked out really, really well. People are out there dancing and eating and having a great time, and I think the Hoermies 2011 turned out to be a total success. And I feel bad about being upset with Jessica. It wasn't her fault. She presented something that needed to be presented. The petting zoo got out of control. We should not have had an open bar with the petting zoo, and that stuff will happen. Next year we learn. And from here on out, I think we will have this party at the office. Because we learned that this is where we work, this is where we live, this is what matters to us. And this is where we become a family.
Style and grace, let me taste these lyrical douches in your bushes. Yeah, who rocks grooves and make moves with all the mommies from the back of the club? Sweet, no way where you find me. Back of the club, I can host my crews behind me. Mad questions asking, blunt passing, music blasting, but I just can't quit because one of these honeys, Biggie, got a creep with, sleep with, keep the ep a secret. Why not? Why blow up my spot? Cause we both got hot, not chicken. I got more Mac than Crip in the bed. Believe me, sweetie, I got enough to feed the needy. No need to be greedy, I got my friends with Benzes, Cinos by the layers, true effing players. Jump in a Rover and come over, tell your friends. Jump.